If you just take a seat, someone will see you shortly.
I was wondering if there's any chance you could take a break.
Doesn't look like it.
I wanted to apologise for last night.
I have never been so embarrassed in my entire life.
I know. I was so out of line.
And in front of all and sundry? It was your sister's special night, for goodness sake.
I'm going to apologise to her.
I should think so. I was very hurt, Maya, that you could even think that way.
It's just we're so stressed out with all the baby stuff, trying to get the money together for the procedure. It's 14 grand and we're nowhere near.
And that's my fault, is it?
It's Jay's. We know. We're just trying to work through that.
By humiliating me?
No, please. It's these hormone injections I have to have. They're making me crazy. I get these raging tempers like I'm some kind of stroppy teen and all this stuff comes out before I even know I've said it. Please forgive me. Please, Mum. I can't do this without you.
Is that all you're having?
I'm not hungry.
You're still upset about last night?
I suppose I am.
It's her hormones, apparently. Guess we have to make allowances.
I realise that now. In fact, I'm beginning to wonder if I've been a bit insensitive towards Maya and Jay.
How?
Not offering them money towards their procedure thingy?
Oh, you still can. I don't mind sharing the money with Maya.
Absolutely not. I'm no Indian giver. There's enough to go around, and it seems only fair, given that I'm paying for your wedding, that I offer the same to them.
Anything to keep Maya from spitting the dummy? I have to get going. You really are a lovely mum.
It's not right. A family fighting over money.
She's really done a number on you.
Pardon?
You didn't want to give Maya that money for a reason, Mum.
No, it just never crossed my mind to offer it, which is why I feel awful, of course.
That is rubbish. Whether you know it or not, there was a reason, a very good reason.
What do you mean?
You never approved of their relationship, and as it turns out, you were right not to.
Yes, but that's
in the past, exactly. And now they're trying to paste over the cracks of their shonky marriage with this baby obsession. And they want you to foot the bill for their madness.
You really think that's what they're trying to do?
Think it. I know it. And finally, Tony's asked if anyone interested in doing extra shifts next week could go and see her, please. Have a good afternoon, everyone. Tonya, could I speak with you for a minute? I am so sorry about last night. I behaved appallingly and you have every right to hate
me. It's okay. I don't.
Really?
Which doesn't mean that I wasn't upset by it. I was disgusted and in front of all of our friends... But I'm not going to give you a hard time about it, because I know I'm going to have to go through the same thing one day, and I might be even more of a cow than you are.
I don't really begrudge you the money for the wedding.
You don't have to anyway.
What do you mean?
Nothing.
Yes, you do. What?
Okay, it's all going to come out in the wash anyway. Mum's decided to give you guys the money for your PGD procedure.
Really?
She wants to be fair to everyone.
Hi, everyone.
Have you got a few minutes?
Yeah, of course.
Now, I'm not going to go on about last night. Maya's already apologised and we've made our peace.
Oh, that's good.
But I am worried about her. How do you think she's coping with all this treatment that she's having?
Well, you've seen for yourself. She's pretty highly strung.
Is it going to be too much for her? For the both of you?
We're coping. I mean, it's a long way to go yet.
Will you get through it?
What do you think?
I don't know.
Exactly. No one knows for sure what's going to happen. We're just trying our best.
The supplier's on the phone again.
Oh, I'm sorry. I've got to take this.
Of course.
Each day as it comes. That's my motto.
No, thanks.
It's not like you.
Well, since our conversation this morning, I've been doing a little soul-searching. I've discussed this with Tanya and Libby, and I wanted to be clear to you all that there is no favouritism in this family.
I know. It's just my irrational brain at the moment.
No, I should have spoken to you first, before I made my offer to Tanya.
Doesn't matter now.
I've also spoken to Jay. She'll probably tell you all about it, but I didn't want you taking offence.
Oh, Mum, I'm not offended. After all the history between you two, I think it's a lovely gesture.
Gesture?
Offering the money to her first. Oh, I'm sorry, but Tanya already told me you wanted to help out with the cost of the PGD, and it is so fantastic.
No, Mum,
I mean it. It's going to make all the difference.
You've got it wrong. I'm sorry. I considered giving you the money, but I've decided against it.
What?
I'm sorry, but I can't support something that I don't believe in.
What did you say to me, Mother?
About what?
You said something to her. You must have, because now she's not giving us any money for the baby.
Oh, man.
What's all mean?
All I did was answer her questions. I didn't realize she was looking for an excuse.
What questions?
Well, she asked me if I thought our relationship could survive the PGD process.
And you said what?
Something like it's not going to be easy, but we're going to give it a go.
Oh, nice.
It's not going to be easy. It wasn't an unreasonable thing to say.
Mama's been searching for an excuse not to help us out, and you just hand her one.
It doesn't matter that Yvonne isn't going to give us any money. We weren't counting on it when we first started out, and we don't need it now. Maya, we can do this on our own.
We are already in debt. It's going to cost us so much just to get the baby, and then how are we going to provide for it? We don't deserve to have a child when we are this broke.
Don't talk like that. I'm sorry. I just had the nicest soak in the bath. I can run you one if you like.
No thanks, I'm a little busy.
Okay, I'll see you in bed.
Yeah.
Babe, would you like me to help you with that?
That hardly makes sense, does it? I'm the nurse, I'm the one that's done it 1,000 times.
Yeah, but there's a difference between giving a patient a jab and giving yourself one.
Oh, Jay, no.
Don't you trust me? You see, if I can learn to do this, then I can give you the injection every time. And then we really are making a baby together.
Well, I suppose when you put it that way.
Sweet! Drop your drawers!
Doesn't go on my butt.
Rightio, is there an art to this?
Stick it in, fast.
Like this?
Oh, sorry.
Oh, no, it's fine.
Okay.
And we're done. What do you reckon? Have I missed my calling? Should I train as a nurse?
I'm sorry for being such a...
You're better a psychotic that Alex. I'm kidding. I know that these drugs are messing with you. And luckily for you, lady, I'm foul certain times of the month too, so I understand.
We can do this?
Damn straight.
New ink cartridge for your printer.
Thanks.
Late night?
Insomnia. It's one of the side effects of the hormone injections. I've had about 2 hours sleep.
I didn't get much sleep last night either, thinking about our discussion. My decision wasn't easy, you know.
Oh, can't be easy, deciding to chuck your life savings at Tanya to get married. She'll have enough money for frocks, flowers, wedding cake, all of which are obviously far more important than a human life.
You see, this is exactly why I can't support what you were doing. Look at you, you're pale, you're sweaty, those hormones are really knocking you around.
Thanks to the Kennedy's disease, if me, Libby or Tanya want to have babies, then this is what we have to do.
I hate seeing you like this. This is why I can't...
Oh, cut the crap, Mum. You honestly expect me to believe that you'd be happy with no grandchildren ever just because we have to have our hormones mucked around with? That is not why you are not supporting me. It's because I'm with Jay. It's because this baby will have two mothers. It's because you are just as narrow-minded and homophobic as you ever were.
It's not because the baby will have two mothers. It's because one of them will be Jay. She hurt you badly, Maya, and you haven't healed yet. You want a baby to make everything all right? Well, it's not going to work. It's a mistake.
A mistake? That's what you think this child will be. Well, you can forget about ever laying your eyes on it.
Maya, please.
Two mothers and no grandmother. I am more than happy with that.
Excuse me, Maya. I need 2 IV lines replaced. I was wondering if I could get someone to give me a hand.
Sure, just grab the river spray.
What I mean is, I was wondering if you could give me a hand. You see, everyone else is busy, and I just...
And with a full patient load and running the ward, I'm somehow not busy? Why do you need a hand anyway? Just do it yourself.
I'm looking for a coffee break, buddy.
Does everyone think I just sit at my desk twiddling my thumbs? I've got about 12 hours work to do and 8 hours to do it in.
Mrs. Tusky. Hormone injections, huh?
I'm a horrible cow.
You see, if I agree with you, then I'm calling you a horrible cow. But if I disagree with you, you may well scream at me anyway, so I think I might just sit here.
I told my mother she wasn't having anything to do with the baby.
Ouch, why?
She changed her mind about helping us out financially because she hates Jay.
She doesn't hate Jay. She doesn't hate anyone.
I know.
Yvonne will come around. And in the meantime, you've got support, okay? Me and Tans are here for you.
I better get on.
So Mum wasn't planning on offering money to help Maya and Jay?
I don't know the details. All I know is my assets are pretty full on thanks to Yvonne.
Oh, boy, this is all my fault. I thought Mum was going to give him some help, so I told Maya. I better go and talk to him.
I wouldn't do that if I was you.
Why not?
The whole hormone injection thing, Maya's pretty scary right now. I tried to talk to her, but I got pushed away.
Of course you did. Of course she wasn't going to talk to you. Her sister, on the other hand.
I don't know, Tans.
But I do. Hormones or not, Mark, I'm going to be there for Maya, okay?
I tried telling her I couldn't help her because I didn't believe in what she was saying.
Maya expected you to help her.
That selfish girlfriend of hers was sitting back allowing Maya to go through hell to have a baby, to send herself bankrupt. And she's going to be a parent while... Maya told me that she wouldn't let me come anywhere near the baby.
What?
I can't help it if I don't have any faith in Jay.
If Maya is saying nasty and vicious things like this to you before she's even pregnant, can you imagine what
she's... It's not her fault. She sees me handing out money to Tanya for the wedding. I suppose she thinks this isn't fair.
You shouldn't be giving either of them a cent. You are a woman on your own, nearing retirement
age. That's not what this is about.
And you are going to throw away your savings on a wedding and a weirdo baby-making mission between groom at said wedding and bride's lesbian sister.
Life was so simple in the Waikato.
Someone that needs to tell Maya where to get off.
Oh, don't. She's hormonal and sleep deprived. You can't go upsetting her.
Mother, you forget. Maya is my sister and she doesn't scare me.